The death toll has reached 74 in Kentucky, 3 nights after a swarm of tornadoes struck. At least 14 people died in Arkansas, Illinois, Missouri, and Tennessee. But the worst was in Mayfield, in far southwestern Kentucky. William Brangham is in the area and begins our coverage.
What else you find?
This is what's left of Michael and Deborah Lynn Long's home after a series of powerful tornadoes ripped through Kentucky and 5 other states on Friday night. Dozens of Kentuckians are confirmed dead, thousands remain without power, and countless homes and buildings across the region have been completely leveled.
We heard a sound that sounded like a train coming, and I said, we have got to go. And it sounded like the wrath of God coming down on you.
Really?
It was horrific.
Michael Long says he and Deborah Lynn survived the terrifying night down in their basement, clinging to the walls of their house in Dawson Springs, Kentucky. Once the storm had passed, he told his wife to brace herself for what she was about to see.
So I told her, I said, you got to be prepared because I think when we go upstairs, there's not going to be nothing. And sure enough, it wasn't much left.
This was the deadliest tornado outbreak in the U.S. in a decade. While deaths have been confirmed in 5 states, Kentucky suffered by far the worst damage and the greatest loss of life. One tornado in Kentucky was on the ground for more than 220 miles, leaving a violent trail of destruction in its wake. In Kentucky, search and rescue operations are ongoing, and dogs are being deployed, hoping to find the more than 100 people who still remain missing.
Just a few more facts about those we've lost.
Kentucky's governor, Andy Beshear, got emotional today describing those who've died.
Of the ones that we know, the age range is 5 months to 86 years, and 6 are younger than 18.
Rescuers are also searching through the rubble of a candle factory in Mayfield, Kentucky, where more than 100 people were working an overnight shift when a twister hit. But Governor Beshear said the factory's death toll could end up being lower than originally feared.
8 are dead. We found 8 bodies, and 8 are missing. We feared much, much worse, and again, I pray that it is accurate.
President Biden has declared a major federal disaster in Kentucky.
I want you to know that this administration has made it clear to every governor, whatever they need, when they need it, make it known to me, and we'll get it to them as rapidly as we can.
Elsewhere in Mayfield, workers continue to clean out buildings downtown as residents struggle to grasp the devastation.
This was a restaurant right here. And as you can see, there's nothing left of it.
Wayne Flint owned a family restaurant in this small western Kentucky town. He'll have to rebuild his business from scratch.
We're just going to clean it up and throw it all away and start again. That's all any of us can do here, you know, because there's nothing worth keeping.
In Illinois, one of the tornadoes blasted through an Amazon warehouse in Edwardsville, killing at least 6 workers. Search efforts are still underway for additional victims. Most of the people on site at the warehouse were contractors brought on for the web giant's Christmas rush. Back in Dawson Springs, Kentucky, Michael Long told us he was able to recover one of his most cherished possessions.
I mean, things like this matters to me. It was my uncle's during World War II.
The Purple Heart his uncle earned when he was killed in World War II. For Deborah Lynn, who lost her first home to Hurricane Katrina 16 years ago, this second loss feels like a curse.
So I feel like most of my life I haven't had a home.
Michael admits that the road ahead will be hard. He's not worried about what he's lost. He's grateful for what he still has.
You know, I still got my granddaughters, I got my daughters, I got my grandson and my wife, and everybody's alive, and we're okay. We can rebuild.
We can rebuild. That is the thing that we have heard from so many people around here. As long as my family is safe, as long as I am healthy and alive, things are just things. We can replace these houses. We can replace these businesses. I mean, given the extent of the destruction here, it is amazing that we haven't seen more people lose their lives. I know those numbers are still changing, but It does seem that the early warnings that this community and this whole region got from meteorologists and their local news and local officials convinced enough people to get out or to seriously hunker down, and that's why they're alive today.
Well, the destruction, William, is just beyond describing. But we saw that you and your team also were in Mayfield, Kentucky today. Give us more of a sense of what you're seeing there.
You're absolutely right, Judy. I mean, I don't even know if this video that we've been filming conveys how bad the destruction is. I mean, we are in the town of Mayfield right now, and it is like an angry, vengeful giant tore through this community, smashing buildings, tearing down power lines, uprooting trees, throwing cars. And we saw a car yesterday that no one in the given neighborhood knew where that car had come from. It had traveled on the wind that far. I talked to a guy today who was a civilian contractor in Iraq, and he said, of all the bombing campaigns I saw, none of the devastation looked like it looks here in Kentucky. So it is just it's really hard to put into words what this community is going through and how they're trying to bounce back from that. There is, of course, an army of volunteers and officials and people trying to put the power lines back up and put Christmas trees and wreaths back on the doors, but it is a very, very scary proposition for a lot of them. I talked with a local county commissioner named Tyler Goodman earlier today. Here's how he described the road ahead.
It is difficult because if you look around, you know, you kind of think, where do I start? You know, you've got buildings that have been here for over 100, 150 years and weathered storms and homes and businesses. And to see the destruction like that, it's hard to think, well, how are we going to deal with this in a week, a month, a year? But I think things will return to normal. It'll just take some time and, you know, take a lot of support.
That's right, Judy. There is this support that is here. They are overwhelmed with support, but it is going to be a very, very long road.
So hard to see all of this. William, we know President Biden has signed emergency declarations for Kentucky and other states. We also know that he's asking federal agencies to look into any link between these terrible tornadoes and climate change. What is known at this point about the link there?
This is a big focus of research, and the evidence right now is just not that clear. We do know that climate change and a warming atmosphere is driving heat waves and intensifying storms and forest fires and droughts. The evidence for those things is quite clear. The evidence for tornadoes and making tornadoes worse is not as clear. It may very well be, but we just don't know yet.
William Brangham reporting for us from Kentucky. Thank you very much.